Hey guys, what's up? I know I said I was finished for the night, but I just ran across this video and I really want to chime in on this one because I just have to chime in on this one. So I want you to listen to this question and then I'm going to respond to it.
Why is it that the African American community finds it so difficult to support our GLBT brothers and sisters? Why is it that we find it so easy to criticize, judge, and look down upon, you know, our fellow gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender brothers and sisters? Why is that? And do you guys feel that Barack Obama...
Okay, so we're going to stop right there with the first question. First of all, I don't think for one second that blacks or the African American community is any different from anyone else. And I hate it when we, black folks, attack each other for something that everybody does. I think too many times we want to say blacks aren't supportive of gays and lesbians. I know a ton of black people who are very supportive of gays and lesbians. I know a ton of white people who are not. I know a ton of Latinos who are supportive of gays and lesbians. I know a lot of Filipinos who are not. So I don't think we can lump this in on any one community. And you guys that watch my channel, you know what I feel about the word community. First of all, when you take, okay, let's just take the gay community. So within the gay community, there are many communities. There's the African American community. There's the Latina community. There's the Asian community. There's the white community. There is the gay with HIV and AIDS community. When I hear the word community, when it applies to people, and when it applies to places like Santa Monica, Venice, Burbank, Brentwood, Bel Air, that's fine. Those are communities. But when I hear it applied to people, I hear barriers. When I hear African American community, it automatically creates a wall, so someone who is white is then excluded or might feel excluded because it's the African American community or it's the HIV community. So it excludes everybody who is not HIV positive. And I'm not saying that that's the way I think, but I think sometimes we create our own problems. We create our own drama by making shit up, by just saying, we're gonna be different and you're gonna accept us and that's the way it is. It's time for us to come out of community and start living the way we were intended to live as humanity, as people. Dr. King did not want us living in communities. He wanted us to live as one group of people in humanity. So I think it is wrong for anyone to say or to anyone to assume that blacks are any more not supportive, and I know I probably said that wrong, that blacks are any more less supportive, thank you, any more less supportive than anybody else. So I'm not buying into that. You can't get me to subscribe to that. Do we have problems as African Americans? Yes, we do. But so does every other culture. I do not think it is inherent to us. I think we are very accepting people. We are very welcoming people. And yes, there is some misunderstanding. There is, and you're right, there is some fear of things we don't know. But that can be true. That can be said for anybody, for any religious background, for any race, any culture, any creed. It's not inherent to black people. So I'll say this. The most stigma that I've experienced has come from the gay community. the most acceptance that I've experienced has come from the straight community. White, black, pink, purple, orange, green, yellow, whatever. The most drama has come from the gay community. So I think it, as a community, we need to stop pointing the fingers at people and start dealing with our own shit. We need to stop saying, oh, well, they did this to me, so I'm going to do this and da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. I just don't get that. No, I'm not going to believe for one second that blacks are less supportive or that blacks aren't willing to be supportive of people who are gay, a transgender, bisexual, whatever the terms are. I think we make all that up and we put it all in our heads. I think the bottom line is this. What are we as individuals doing to help educate people? That's what we should be looking for. Because if we could spend all day finding the things that are wrong instead of working on solutions to make things better. And I think that's what we should be concentrating on. Here's the next question. And this one is about Barack Obama. And I wish everybody would just get off my brother's dick.
Obama is holding up his, basically end of the deal. One of the reasons he was elected was because of the GLBT community. He made certain promises to the GLBT community. And do you guys feel that he is, living up to his promises, living up to what he said he will be doing? Use this video as a venue to discuss.
Okay, so as far as Barack Obama is concerned, me personally, I think the man is doing a pretty good job. Give this man a chance. Everybody thinks that he's going to go hocus pocus, whip out Moses' magic stick, and everything is going to be fixed overnight. This country is fucked. Let's just look at things for where they are, people. We cannot expect this man to fix things overnight. And let's not exaggerate that it was because the GLBT community that he was elected. Let's not exaggerate that. Because if the GLBT community had that much power, gay marriage wouldn't be an issue right now. If they had that much power. So let's stop pretending. Let's stop attacking the man and start supporting him. Again, I think we can spend so much time on what he's not doing or what we perceive him not to be doing instead of saying, yes, we need to support him on this. Right now, this man, this is the first president I can remember that's willing to fight for universal health care, which includes gays, lesbians, bisexuals, transgenders. And I hear more people speaking out about this. Where's the gay community on that? Where is the gay community in their support of? I think sometimes when you get into a community, and I'm getting back to my original point, when you get locked into these communities that separate people, all you think about is your community. Instead of thinking globally, instead of thinking about fellow Americans, how is this going to affect the Chinese woman up the street who's straight with three kids? How's this going to affect the white woman living down on Skid Row? How's this going to affect the straight black man who's doing all he can? I think we need to break out of these communities because communities divide us. They separate us. They cause tension. They make us different. We're all the same. When we all get cut, we're all gonna bleed the same red blood. It's time for us to start thinking about what's best for this nation and not what's best for a community. Because when you think in community, you exclude other people. And that's just what I think. I am gay, I am black, I am HIV positive, but I would much rather be working towards a better humanity than a better community. That's what I would be working on. So to recap, I don't think blacks are any more guilty than anybody else of not supporting or being judgmental. That is a human condition. It is not a black condition. It is a human condition, and I wish people would stop. I wish we, black people, would stop making it as such. It is a human condition which we all suffer from. Blacks do not own the patent on this. And let's look at all the bad things that churches are supposedly doing. But what about the black churches that are standing up? What about the black people that are standing up, that are willing to fight? That you discount that when you lump it all together. Let's break out of community and get with humanity, people. Let's get real. Support Obama. Let's come on now.